Psst. Yeah, you, come here. Haven't you heard? We don't need to hide anymore. Now, we can shop privately for adult products at adamandeve.com. They've got massage oils, lingerie, and lots more we can't mention here. Use offer code SPICE404. They'll give you 50% off almost any one item, 3 free DVDs, free mystery gift, and free shipping. That's 50% off, free shipping, and more. Private shopping starts at adamandeve.com.
Turnpike Sports Book Report.
The Turnpike Sports Book Report is brought to you by BorgataSports.com. Your favorite casino is now your favorite sports book, available anywhere in New Jersey, BorgataSports.com. Sign up at BorgataSports.com using our promo code PIKE, that's P-I-K-E. Make your first wager of $20 or more and you'll get $100 in free bets. That's $100 in free bets when your first wager on Borgata Sports is $20 or more. Get into the action with BorgataSports.com. Must be 21 years or older and in New Jersey to place a bet. Terms and conditions apply. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
And welcome to another edition of the Book Report, where we're going to talk about what's happening in the sports books around the country and also in some cases internationally as well this week. We've got a bunch of interesting news topics here. We got a new state. We got a new country joining the sports betting community. We have a brand new brand becoming a sports betting entity, as well as Bally's continuing their expansion and a sports book launching for the first time out of Nevada. We're going to start off with welcoming Louisiana as the 30th state in this country to legalize sports betting.
Yeah, that was a long time coming. I was waiting for Louisiana, and they finally did it. They pulled the trigger.
Well, they had passed it during the November elections.
Yep.
And just last week, Governor John Bel Edwards signed the bills into law. So they're hoping to have everything up and running by the start of the NFL season.
Which is, what, 2
September
months?
September 9th, something like that, is the first day that everyone's, that's usually the target. They're hoping to have it up and running. A lot of states have
that's
also
actually
said
pretty
that's
quick. A, good for them.
Well, yeah. they've had this stuff in motion since the November election. The different bills set out the different tax rates, the licensing structures. They have everything all set to go. It's just a matter of moving ahead, just like Arizona. Arizona's moving quick, too.
Yeah.
They just released some of their published rules. They're going to have some more going ahead, more public committee meetings, but they're shooting for the start of the NFL season, too. Canada is the brand new country in North America that has legalized sports betting.
Well, they had some form of legal sports betting. I think it was the parlay method, which was for a long time Delaware had that. But now it's, what are they calling it? The
single event sports betting.
Okay, single event sports betting.
It's Canadian Sports Betting Bill C218 has made it all the way through the initial readings through their parliament. And they don't have sports betting up and running yet. It's the bill allows the provinces to legalize sports betting. Now it's up to the provinces to get moving. From all indications, Ontario is expected to be the first province to be up and running by the start of the NFL season.
Okay.
The other two big provinces, British Columbia and Alberta, they're launching later than Ottawa, Ontario, and probably by early 2022. And what they're saying is by the end of 2022, around 64% of the population of Canada will have access to legal sports betting and also online gaming.
Great. Good for them.
So that's the other thing. I always found it interesting that with the casino industry up in Canada, I'm surprised they didn't have online gaming up until this bill.
Yeah, no, it should be interesting once they get online gaming, because the big thing, especially in the United States, especially with online poker, they have a the shared player pools. I wonder if there could be an international agreement between Canada and the U.S. for online poker. It would be absolutely amazing if they did.
Well, it's going to be more interesting to see what Canada does internationally outside of North America, because online poker is still very popular overseas, more sure. so than the United States. You know, we have that situation there that where Black Friday happened and everybody was, you know, deemed you couldn't do online poker for a while. And we're just starting to get back into the online poker industry in this country.
Yeah, well, the pandemic really boosted the numbers for online poker and online gaming in the U.S. I mean, living in New Jersey, we have the we have online casinos and we have online poker. And online poker, we have the multi-state compact where, you know, I play poker games against people in Nevada while sitting in New Jersey, which is great. The WSOP has that, WSOP.com.
Yes. So, you know, it'll be interesting to see whether or not Canada does international first before they're able to do anything with the United States for online poker. I don't have too much hope that that'll happen very quickly with the United States, the way we approach online poker in this country. But again, welcome Louisiana, welcome Canada. I wish we could welcome even more, but it looks like Maine is a little, you know, stuck in the mud right now. Maybe by the end of the month, something will happen with the legislation there, and it'll go to the governor's desk. But again, everyone's got to remember the Maine governor vetoed it at the last moment last year too. Or two years ago, 2019.
I'm fascinated what's happening in Maine. I'm fascinated what's happening in Ohio with, you know, sports betting. It just seems like, you know, once you think progress is being made, and then the rug is pulled out from under you.
Well, again, it should have happened. I mean, last week it should have happened. And at the last moment, you know, they attached the sports betting to this veterans ID bill in Ohio.
This is Ohio.
And, you know, everything should have worked out that way. I mean, it set up everything perfectly. And from what I'm reading, they didn't even bother discussing it. They're going to approach it later this month.
Well, we'll see what happens. Like I said, Maine and Ohio are very interesting states when it comes to progress of sports betting. So we'll see.
And don't forget about Florida. Florida is getting interesting. We just had supposedly a ballot initiative that's being pushed by unknown groups, but it looks like FanDuel and DraftKings, to have a sports betting amendment added to the Constitution so that it doesn't become exclusive property of the Seminoles down there.
All right, well, we'll see what happens. Yeah,
they're pushing another ballot amendment, signature drive, that sort of thing. Let's see. Going over into, well, I teased it at the beginning. We had a brand new brand coming into the sports betting industry, and that is Sports Illustrated.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I really like Sports Illustrated. They actually have a gambling section. I love their analysis. I love their, you know, their articles. And, you know, it came as, you know, it was a surprise to hear you're talking about the deal with 888.
888 right? Holdings and,
yeah. And it looks like the
Authentic Brands Group, which owns Sports Illustrated.
So it looks like he's going to be sports betting, especially online sports betting.
So online sports betting.
And iGaming.
Yep.
Right? It's not only sports betting, from what I understand.
They're going to be doing two platforms, one for online gaming, one for sports betting, with 888.
Mm-hmm.
888 Holdings, I should say. That's the proper name of the company. They are looking at launching the SI Sportsbook. And, you know, before we get into that, SI has such a following. I think been reported their monthly users are around 30 million. So they have a built-in audience for that brand.
Absolutely.
For this book.
I'm one of their readers. So I'd be very interested in seeing what SI has in the offerings of sports betting and, you know, iGaming too, you know.
Well, they're going to be doing a couple different things with this. Not only the sports book, but they're also going to be launching a gambling-themed issue of the Sports Illustrated magazine in August.
Okay.
So it's going to be all gambling. This next issue or this upcoming issue.
I'll have to pick it up.
And also you mentioned their website.
That's going to be like a collector's edition kind
probably,
of thing.
Probably. But you, for me anyway. But you know, you mentioned the website where you use their gambling section.
Yeah.
They're going to be doing more.
Good.
They're going to be launching enhanced and comprehensive coverage of the sports betting space, including in-depth analysis, tools, and widgets.
Okay.
So they're going to be going all in with the sports betting theme even more than they have already.
Great. Oh, hey, I read it every week, so it's great.
And they are planning for the SI Sportsbook. I don't know if they're going to, I guess it's going to be SI Sportsbook. It may not be Sports Illustrated Sportsbook. I don't know exactly how they're going to call it. but it's SI. I'm going to use SI Sportsbook. Their first state looks to be Colorado.
Okay.
Right. Well, seems Colorado is, you know, the shooting star here. Everyone,
well, me being in New Jersey, I hope they come to New Jersey pretty soon.
Well, they do plan to have New Jersey, Indiana, and Iowa as the next states up for possible launches.
Great.
For the sportsbook.
Good.
So, but again, they're going to start out in Colorado, which leads me to Colorado and their sports betting numbers for May.
Oh, okay.
For a segue?
I got to ask. I'm fascinated every time I look at Colorado. How did table tennis do?
Depends on how you read the stats.
Okay. Is it top 10?
It is.
Okay. Right.
If you look at it,
it's usually
terms,
around 5 or 6.
See, Colorado reports the individual sports, and then they have the other category, the parlays category.
Okay.
Table tennis is set out separately. In a lot of states, table tennis is part of the other.
Okay.
But here in Colorado, table tennis was technically the fourth most bet on sport in terms of handle.
Wow.
They had...
Was something happening in table tennis last month that I don't know about?
They came in with $10.253 million in handle. $10.24 million of it was online.
And this is for...
Table tennis in Colorado for May.
Table tennis
this
in Colorado.
This is just May.
Wow.
4.1% of the total handle. Overall, it came in six, because if you factor in the other category, the parlay category, they had more. But that's like a bucket category. So depending on how you want to read it. But
wow, can you imagine doing a table tennis parlay? I don't.
People do that.
Wow. I got to learn more about this sport.
Well, basketball was the top sport, under 87 million and 85.8 million via online. Let me tell you something right now. Before I forget, the total sports betting handle was just under $249 million. One of the few states that had an increase from April, by the way.
Okay.
99% of the total handle came from online.
See, that's interesting, because I know everything is opening up. I would think, you know, there'd be a little less online. You know, people are getting out, getting back to the sports books and going to the sports books to eat and drink and watch the games. And I'm surprised 99% is still online.
Well, you know, it's a matter of convenience.
Well, although, as you know, as I do, even though if I go to a sports book, I still place my bets on my phone when I'm in the sports book. So instead of me getting up and going online, or if I win, I don't have to go back up and collect my money. It already goes into the account. So even if I'm attending, I'm in a sports book, I still place my bets online on my phone.
Well, also, it's a factor of how close are these casinos to one another.
Yeah.
You know, if you go down to Atlantic City, you could walk from casino to casino to casino to casino, you know, within, they're next to each other on the boardwalk, except for Borgata, Golden Nugget, and Harris. Everyone else is on the boardwalk, and they all have sports books.
Mm-hmm.
But again, it's a matter of, you know, if you're sitting in one casino in Cripple Creek, how close is the next casino to you? If you don't want to walk down the street or drive down the street, you know, you just take your phone out and start betting online. I mean, it's a matter of convenience as well, too. And with Colorado reporting their handle numbers, 2021's national handle passed $19 billion. That is just an incredible number. And when you look at it from last year's perspective, and again, you got to factor in COVID with 2020 numbers. The national handle of all of last year was $21.5 billion.
Okay.
So we're almost touching the total handle of last year in half a year this year.
Yep.
Operator revenue has also cleared the $4 billion mark in the post-PASPA era after this half year was passed here. It's just kind of, you know, growing and growing and growing.
Oh, absolutely. And then, you know, the numbers are going to be astronomical in the coming months and the next year. So.
And also the gaming firm Eilers & Krejcik, they released a report, and there was an interesting breakdown of leading sports betting operators.
Okay.
Flutter Entertainment, which is FanDuel, and I believe also at some point Fox Bet's also part of that too. Leading sports betting operator in 5 states, Illinois, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Virginia, and West Virginia. DraftKings, Indiana, Iowa, and New Hampshire. And that makes sense in New Hampshire. They're the only one in New Hampshire. And BetMGM is first in Michigan, Colorado, and Tennessee.
Okay.
The only place William Hill leads, well, actually it's Caesars Entertainment's William Hill, is Nevada.
Okay.
Which still has the in-person requirement.
Okay.
So, and at some point, William Hill is going to be Caesar Sports.
Wait, you have to explain that. The in-person requirement means if you sign up, if you start your registration for an online sports book in Nevada, you have to finish your registration at the physical sports book.
So. Every there's a bunch of different brands out there, but again, they all have the in-person requirement. But I was actually moving to having William Hill when Caesars finishes the acquisition of everything. They're going to be flipping over to Caesar Sports.
Okay.
There won't be a William Hill in the United States. It'll be Caesar Sports.
I find that hard to believe. Unbelievable. William Hill.
I'm assuming they're going to keep some sort of the brand alive in the United States. But
it's such a huge name in sports betting. I'm very curious to see how they're going to do the marketing.
Well, it'll be there. They've also said that they're going to try and sell the overseas assets of William Hill. I think 888 mentioned that they were interested in purchasing the William Hill assets, or Bet365, one of the other groups out there that are pretty big over in the UK and overseas.
We'll have to take a look at the stock exchanges for these acquisitions.
Well, hey, you also have some of the ETFs now, too.
Yep.
You know, they've got to take a look at all the indexes. Staying in Colorado, we had the first Superbook Sportsbook retail launch outside Nevada in Colorado.
Wow.
They launched at the Lodge Casino in Blackhawk. That's the other big town for casinos. You have Cripple Creek and Blackhawk. It's their first retail location outside of Nevada, outside of Las Vegas, actually. 7,000 square foot sports book, 28 state of the art television screens, 3 betting windows and kiosks located throughout the casino itself. And at the ribbon cutting, they had former Denver Bronco Mark Schlereth.
Oh, okay.
Do the first bet and the ribbon cutting.
All right.
So you know he bet on the Broncos.
I'm always curious. I love the openings of sports books because I want to see who they have make the first bet and the ribbon cutting. It's always a great time.
Well, again, it's I always like who they get as the local celebrities. You know, I remember one of the ones in Atlantic City had Dr. J there for their opening. I think it was Borgata, wasn't
Borgata,
it?
Borgata. I think Borgata had Dr. J. Yeah, the interesting thing was Ocean Resort. Remember that? They had Mark Wahlberg.
Yeah.
Because he has a
Wahlburgers.
Wahlburgers in
his burger Ocean chain. Resort. His burger
chain. Burger chain, yeah.
Yeah, so there's going to be more of those coming into casinos. If you like Wahlburgers, I'm not a huge fan of the burgers themselves, but if you like them. Two other interesting launches that happened. DraftKings. They launched DraftKings Social.
So is this a play money type of thing?
No, this is a community, like a Facebook community, incorporated into the sportsbook.
Oh, okay.
You can actually make friends, interact with certain people, share your bets with other people. They can share their bets with you.
Yeah, I notice BetMGM and also Borgata, when you make a bet on the online sports book, they have a button where you can share it to Twitter or share it to Facebook.
A lot of people are getting that, but this is a self-contained.
I've never done that, by the way.
This is a self-contained social community within DraftKings. They launched it for the fantasy site first, then they're going to do the sports book. And also the online casino.
Okay.
They do not have any plans to do a poker product, they said.
All right.
So I didn't even know DraftKings had any involvement with poker, to be honest with you. Okay. I didn't even know that.
No, I did not know that either.
So it was just nice to see it's becoming a little bit more social environment. You can share your bets, all that. So you can actually go back and forth with people on with chats.
Great.
So
great.
That's one of the things that launched there. And Tane. This I found very interesting. If you love virtual reality stuff, this is very interesting. Entain will be launching a virtual reality sports club entertainment experience. That's how they phrased it, for virtual reality.
Now, is this an in-person kind of thing?
This is sitting at home. You put on your Oculus Quest 2 headset.
Big thing. Okay, all right.
It's free through the Oculus Quest 2 headset. They're offering it for free.
Those are those big headsets that you put on your face, right?
Yeah,
It's the virtual reality.
I always think when I see those headsets, and it's a horrible thing to think of, you see, I remember the old Flash Gordon movie, all the guys controlling the shield on Ming's Palace with the big glasses on their head, that sort of thing. I always think of Flash Gordon when I see that.
What a cryptic reference. Wow. Everyone's going to have to go back and look at the movie now.
I'm sorry, people, because it was not that great of a movie to begin with, but it was. It just makes me think of that about that scene there. But
you have these things on your face. You have the goggle. I don't know if you call them goggles, but you have the Oculus.
They call it a headset.
On, and you'll watch these virtual games. Right now, does that have something to do with betting, or some? Can you actually do betting things?
Well, the hope is they're going to be able to do all that because their initial statement, they're going to be able to have customers live stream football matches, build fantasy lineups, and play a range of different sports games while you're in this sports club virtually.
All right.
So if you're going to be able to build fantasy lineups, you know you're going to be able to do a parlay lineup or a betting lineup or something like that. But they're going to be doing that. They're going to also have music experiences inside this club. So it's going to be just like going to a sports bar, but virtually.
Okay, all right.
And this is through Verizon Media. They did a deal with them last year to do something like this. And now they're going to be rolling it out later on this year, sometime after August, from what I was reading about, what they can, what they're going to be doing there. So a new virtual experience is coming your way if for sports fans, not only fantasy, but I would assume sports betting at some point, mm-hmm. although they didn't directly mention it. Sport Radar launched a tech setup here, a product, first of its kind called Embet, E-M-B-E-T.
Embet, okay.
It's a first-of-a-kind product that integrates real-time live sports betting content to an OTT streaming device.
Okay, all right. And I have one of those, so I can check it out.
And it features live data, odds, insights, and advertising all in one spot. So this is really, this is for the B2B. This is an industry thing. You'll see the end product, but this is they've launched it for their business partners to incorporate into their OTT devices.
Okay, now I have Roku. If I wanted to check,
don't
this
ask
out,
me that specific
I don't,
question.
You don't know. Okay,
they just launched it.
Okay, so it's not Sport Radar isn't going to have a channel. Sport Radar is going to have business partners where they're going to have Sport Radar,
right.
This Embet,
this is basically
into its programming. Okay.
This will basically function as a management tool.
Okay. All right.
Where you control everything, your odds feed, your content feed, and your advertising feed all in one spot, okay. Which I think is an incredible development. It simplifies everything in terms of how you can go about creating live betting through an OTT stream.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you might see something like that with Fubo when they go live with what they're planning on doing. They're trying to do the odds content and the live betting inside the one stream as well.
Yeah.
So,
well, I notice Fubo TV has an OTT channel.
Yes.
So
yes, but it's they're beta testing the live betting through their trivia contests and
this
all that.
This is Fubo TV.
The Fubo, yeah.
Fubo TV.
Not Fubo. Fubo's the apparel. Fubo's the apparel.
I keep saying that. Fubo TV.
Yeah.
So that's what you're talking about. Okay.
A couple other pieces of legislation. We talked about the legalization of sports betting in Louisiana and Canada. We've got New Jersey. The assembly passed the fixed odds bill for Monmouth Park horse racing. That's something.
It's about time. That was a long time going.
They've been pushing it. They got it through. It's going to go to the governor. By the time this airs, he may have even signed it, but they're hoping to have fixed odds betting in place for the Haskell coming up at Monmouth.
Which, for people who don't know, is a huge horse race in
New
Jersey. So.
One other little note from the New Jersey Senate. They voted 40-0 in favor of a bill requiring the harness racing tracks in the state, which is Meadowlands and Freehold.
Yes.
To continue to host races as a condition to maintaining their sports betting licenses. I guess they're afraid of them stopping racing altogether and becoming a sports book.
Well, look, sports betting in New Jersey was supposed to help the horse racing industry. So, it makes sense that, the Senate would want them to continue racing.
Well,
they got their schedule.
They got it. So they actually have required the horse tracks to actually continue racing. So a couple of other deals to hit real quick here. Bally's has continued their expansion across the United States. They just did a multi-year arrangement with the Boot Hill Casino and Resort in Dodge City, Kansas.
Okay.
Boot Hill will be implementing the Bally Bet app once sports betting is legalized in that state, if and when. Mm-hmm. That's another state that's a question mark. That deal gives them market access into their 14th state. They're in, besides Kansas now, Colorado, Delaware, Iowa, Indiana, Illinois, Kansas, Louisiana, Missouri, Mississippi, New Jersey, Nevada, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, and Virginia. They only have, this is also their third state where they don't have a physical property.
Okay.
So there's no Bally's property in Kansas as we speak. BetRivers did a deal with Chicago Bears, NFL team. Mm-hmm. First deal for the Chicago Bears in this in the gaming space.
Okay.
They are, BetRivers becomes the official sports book, and the land-based casino, Rivers Casino in Chicago, becomes the Bears' official casino partner.
Okay.
It's for, like I said, first exclusive deal for the Bears. I'm actually surprised it's their first one. Everybody else has been doing deals left and right, and I guess the Bears have been a little slow on this too.
Yeah, no, I'm surprised. BetRivers is great and Bears are great, so it should be a good partnership.
And they're going to be the BetRivers will also be the title partner of their free to play game, available on the Chicago Bears official app.
Okay.
So if you download the Bears app, you can actually play the free-to-play game.
Okay.
That's BetRivers branded.
One of those predictive games, right?
Yeah. I'm just surprised. BetRivers has done some really nice stuff. They did the BetRivers Lounge at PPG Paints Arena, which is the Penguins, the hockey team.
Pittsburgh Penguins,
the National Hockey League team. Also, BetRivers did the corporate partnership with the soccer franchise of the United Soccer League, the Indy 11. So they're getting really involved in the sports betting scene in terms of the actual league sports, too.
Great.
Unibet, and we just had Joe Soloski on the show talking about NASCAR. Speaking of NASCAR, Unibet did a deal with Stuart Haas Racing.
Wow, great.
Kevin Harvick is going to be the main driver of a Unibet-sponsored car, as well as they're going to be the sponsor of the team as well, the Stuart Haas Racing team.
You know, you do these stories, and now, you know, I automatically now go to NASCAR to see, you know, who the sponsors are on the car. So now I have to check out, take a look for Unibet.
Well, that's kind of why they do these sponsors.
Yeah, and, yeah, no, that's why.
And the last deal for this week, Betway announced a partnership with Nordia Open, becoming the official betting partner for the event. This has the Nordia Open has been voted as tennis players. Top 250 tournament of the year for the past 11 consecutive years. So it's the top ATP tournament.
Okay.
That Betway has sponsored. And Betway's been doing a lot of stuff.
You know, the first time I saw Betway was a couple, like a few months ago, and I was watching a New York Islanders hockey game, and I saw Betway on the boards. And I was like wondering, what is Betway? And now I haven't stopped hearing about them.
No, and you're going to hear more because intend to be doing a lot more sponsorships, and it's a brand to watch.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I didn't know what it was 4 or 5 months ago, but now
it's everywhere.
And now it's everywhere.
Well, that's it for this week's book report. Whatever we did not hit, and believe me, there is a lot of stuff we did not hit in the time allotted here. Just head on over to TurnpikeSportsRadio.com, click on the blog button, and you'll see a print version of the stories we talked about, as well as stories we did not hit in this segment, up on the blog after this episode of the book report publishes.
And that'll do it for us this week. We'll see you next time on the Turnpike.